What's up, runners? I am Coach Holly.
Coach Elizabeth.
And today we're going to tell you how to start running and give you our workout for new runners specifically. We know how hard it is to get started with that running. It is not easy for anybody. We're going to give you our best tips, talk about why it's hard, as well as walk you through this workout start to finish.
All right, none of us starts running as an expert. There's always that kind of difficult learning curve that's associated with running. It's painful, it's awkward, you're short of breath, right? It's
totally.
It's something that we all have to learn how to do when we start.
Exactly, and no matter who you are, what kind of athlete, or maybe even DNA that you're coming from, your parents were great athletes, we all have to experience those first couple of attempts at a run. So, one of the big things we want to talk about today is how do you even logistically start to run? Do you just throw on your shoes, make your best effort for 5 to 10 minutes and decide you never want to try it again? Because that's what happens to a lot of you, and we know how that goes. Today we're actually going to get into a workout that we've designed to get you warmed up to the idea of running for an extended period of time. We're going to give you something with broken up exercises, kind of mixing things up. You won't be running the whole time. You can even walk if you need to. And we're gonna use Elizabeth here to demonstrate all of the movements. Let's get into the workout.
All right, Holly, I've got my shoes, I'm motivated, I'm ready to get started. What do I do?
Perfect, so we've already started with a good attitude. That is step one. Not hard with Elizabeth here, but that is definitely step one if you wanna have success this first workout. Our workout today is going to be short run, come back. We're going through three different exercises or movements. We'll talk about those. You'll then finish with a nice big rest, and then you'll repeat this for a few rounds. First part of this is going to be a 400 meter run or walk or combo of those two things. 400 meters, for those of you who are not familiar, is one lap around a track, about half the distance of a football field, and about a quarter mile. So this should take you, I want you to move for no longer than about 3 minutes, maybe 3.5 minutes on this. So whatever you need to do to move that distance, that's great. So if you're not quite getting to that 400 meter mark, that's okay. This is more about just getting that heart rate up a little bit before we get into some strength movements. So I'm gonna send Elizabeth off on her 400 meter run. She is gonna think about nice deep breaths, staying consistent, and not going out of the gate too fast because she's got a lot more when she comes back. So, you ready to do it?
I'm ready to do it.
All right, let's go. So while she takes off on this run, I just want to talk about a few options you guys have. If this is not going to be a full run for you and you've just never really gotten into running before, that's fine. I might recommend a couple, maybe 15 to 20 seconds of a jog going into a walk, maybe 15, 20 seconds jog going into a walk, or even just trying to jog for a minute or two and then walk back for the second half of that 400 meters. So do this how you need to. Again, the purpose is getting that heart rate up. It's not about full on sprint, come back, and then try to knock out these movements. Again, this is for new runners. All right, she did it, 400 Woo! Meters. How was it?
It was great.
Awesome.
Feels good to move.
Awesome. So she comes back from that 400 meter, again, run, jog, walk, whatever it is. We're now gonna go into a set of 10 push-ups. Don't be freaked out if you don't know what you're doing with push-ups. We're gonna walk you through the most beginner version into a little bit more advanced for those of you who need it. So I'm gonna have Elizabeth start in a plank position, right here. We're looking at wrists right under the shoulders, nice flat back, pull that belly button up a little bit, good. Butt squeezed, and then legs together. So that's what we want for that starting position of the push-up. For this first version, all she's gonna do is drop just her knees to the ground, and she's gonna follow with elbows in tight to the sides all the way till her chest hits. Good, again, she's trying to keep a nice flat back here. From here, she's gonna push up just the chest off the ground, and then she's gonna press off her knees to come back and find that plank position. Good, let's see one more of those. So she's gonna go knees down, all the way down for the chest, keep that butt squeezed. She's gonna push that chest off the ground again, and then off the knees. Good, you can rest for a sec. This is gonna be the first version of this push-up. You're doing 10 of these ideally, and I want you to just break it up however you need to. So that can be sets of two, you stand up, shake your arms out, go back down. Sets of three, maybe two sets of five, whatever you think you can handle. If that's already feeling okay, let's talk about a little bit of a harder version. She's gonna hit that plank again. nice flat back, but squeezed again. She's taking nice big breaths. And now she's gonna go strict as much as she can all the way down. So elbows in, you're gonna take that knee part out till she's laying down basically on the ground. She can even rest all the way down on the ground if she wants. It's nice and gross out here. And then from here, she's gonna push off and roll off her knees just like she did before. Chest comes up, knees come off. One more of those. She's gonna go strict down, relax, and then you're gonna go chest up, knees up from here, and rest. Perfect, she can stand on up. That's gonna be version two. The final version, which I'm not even gonna make her do today, but is gonna be a strict push-up. Eventually, I hope that you work up to this. This is gonna be nice, strong plank position. You know what, I'm gonna show you a couple. I'm gonna go down into that plank position, keep everything tight, and I'm gonna rock forward, elbows in, and then press up at the top, just like this. Again, if I wanna try a couple of those mixed in, you're going for 10 reps here. That's all I care about, is working on that push-up for 10 reps. We will get into the next movement in a second. So we've hit that 400 meter run, those 10 push-ups, and now we're going into a set of air squats. So, just like the push-ups, these air squats are designed in this workout to actually make your running stronger. You may not see that right now, but the air squats are gonna help us work on a nice forward hip position, strong glutes, and just all over strong legs, so that from that repetitive running motion, we're not just getting stuck on one set of muscles through the whole thing. You're gonna learn to run upright, nice good form, and just really feel a lot stronger on your legs. So what we're gonna do for this air squat, Elizabeth's gonna find a stance just about hip width apart. She knows the drill here. If you need to slightly turn your toes out to the corners, that's totally okay, but we're aiming for a mostly straightforward foot position there. From here, she's gonna act like she's sitting in a chair. So she's gonna sit the hips back, but keep her core engaged, and she's just gonna kinda sit those hips back and press those knees out a little bit. Perfect, good. And then she's gonna stand back up. She's gonna try the same thing now, pulling that belly button in, and she's gonna bring the arms out just a little for that counterbalance. And she's gonna sit just a little bit deeper so we can find more of a parallel position to the ground. Perfect, good, she stands back up. Let's see a couple more of those. Pressing those knees away from each other. You wanna pretend you have two walls on either side of the knees so that when you go down, there's some resistance, even imaginary resistance going on between the ankles and then the knees as well.
So if I feel my legs going out,
yes,
do I not go as deep? Like, do I start shallow and then work up to that?
Exactly. So if that is a mobility range of motion here, so say your ankles are tight, you know, your hips are tight, this is just not gonna happen for you. Couple options. You can put something under your heels, maybe a small, like a 10 pound plate, or you can just not go as low. As soon as you start to feel the heels come up or the knees jet over the toes, that's too far down. So just play with a few of these just to get started. So we'll just see a couple more here. Good, so it's looking pretty good there. And then again here, guys, we're just working on that repetitive motion. So you have 20 reps of this in this round, whatever that means for you. Again, you can even put a box behind you to kind of tap on and sit on as you go. She's got 20 air squats just like this. We have one more movement left in this workout. Last movement in this workout is going to be a 30 second reverse plank hold. Elizabeth, are you familiar with the reverse plank hold?
I'm not.
Awesome. I actually wasn't until recently either, but I have realized it is a really awesome tool to strengthen our position as we're running, just like those push-ups and the squats. This one burns a little bit more, but I would say it's a little bit more effective than the two of those. So we're gonna go down to the ground here. Instead of a normal plank like you started for those push-ups, she's gonna be flipped over now. So legs are still together. Now she's gonna have her hands behind her and she's gonna lift those hips up, butt squeezed. We're trying to find a nice straight diagonal position here. You can see she is struggling a little bit to figure out what to do with her head. The sun is blasting into her eyes. And it's tempting because your head weighs a lot. So you're gonna wanna throw it back, but she's gonna keep a nice neutral chin there. And just like this, you can rest for a second. The goal here is just to keep that flat position. That's all it's gonna be, and for 30 seconds. If you are finding trouble holding it that long, just come down when you need to. I just want you to accumulate 30 seconds. So that can be 10, 10, 10. If you can only do it in increments of 5 seconds, that's totally fine. Work on nice deep breaths here, squeezing as soon as you feel those hips start to drop, really trying to engage that position, squeezing the legs together as well. And then you can point those toes down just for an added little kick on the back of those calves. Everything else will be nice and tight and engaged just like you would be in a normal plank.
All right there, beginning runners. Coach Holly has taken all the guesswork out of how to start. We have that step-by-step guide so we can get going.
Exactly. Thanks so much to Elizabeth for helping me out, showing you guys what to do. Just one more recap of what you're going to be doing here. All the movements we just gave you, including that run, that 400 meters at the beginning, is going to all be repeated a few times based on your level. We've got the whole workout down in the description for you, but again, you're running 400 meters or walking or jogging. You come back, you hit your 10 push-ups, whatever variation you can hold. You hit your 20 air squats, again, at whatever depth you can maintain, and then your 30-second reverse plank hold, all followed by at least 1 minute of full rest. That's to catch your breath, shake your arms out, get your legs ready to go for that next run. You are gonna do this anywhere from 3 to 5 times all the way through. Remember that as the weeks go on, as you start to feel a little bit more comfortable with this workout, that's always a good time to kind of realize, could I make this a little bit harder for myself? So say I started with a 400 meter walk for the first couple of weeks. By week 3, week 4, could I maybe up that to maybe half of that being a little jog of some sort? Could I add a round, that kind of thing? Could I minimize the rest? There's always ways to improve as long as you're, you know, keeping track of how it's feeling for you. In this last section coming up, we are just gonna talk about our last favorite tips for starting to run. Guys, Elizabeth is now a great runner and someone I've always looked up to in her running, and I feel like she is the best person to kind of give you her ways that she got through this initial beginning running period. What are your tips for them?
So my two tips would be, the first one is get some accountability, enlist a friend. Running with friends is a lot more fun and it makes that beginning learning process a little less awkward.
Definitely.
The next one would be trusting the process. We all were beginners at one point in time and it felt awkward. And if you believe that you're going to get better and that it will get easier, one day 400 meters is not gonna be enough.
Exactly.
So it does evolve, I promise.
Exactly. Trust that process, guys. Grab that buddy to help you out. And remember that these circuit style workouts are an awesome jumping off point to just start to get used to that running. Like she said, eventually one day this workout won't be enough for you. Guys, again, if you are looking to start running yourself and you need that perfect training plan, we have some awesome ones up on our site as part of our training club. We have a beginner running program that walks you through complete 30 days, getting you from the couch all the way to that first race distance. Check that out down below in the description.
If you liked this video, be sure and click the like button. Leave us a comment, let us know how you're starting on your new training, and click the subscribe so that you are first to get all of the new videos that come out every week.
And thanks again for working out with us today, guys. We will catch you in the next video.